Welcome back to the channel. I'm going to show you guys how to do smart reframe on the free version of Resolve. So let's see what smart reframe is doing. If we take this clip here, we'll go ahead and reset it. It's 16 by 9 clip, and I just put a 9 by 16 graticule over the top here. Let's go ahead and hit smart reframe. It's going to analyze the clip. And then if we play it back, we can see the subject's pretty much centrally located. Now there's a black bar, so it needs to be repoed. But essentially, it's done what we asked. But how is it doing it? Let's check out the inspector down here and move over to the transform. When we hit transform, you can see all these keyframes, kind of like your dynamic zoom in a way. Well, we're doing it with keyframes on positions instead of a global zoom in and zoom out. Now, these are actually editable, and I just found that out recently, where you could grab these, move them around. You can right click and delete them. You can smooth them out. We're just going to mimic this without using smart reframe. So let's go ahead and reset this clip and we'll go to a central spot. You could see now if we get off screen, our subject's off screen. So I'm going to go to about the center here where they happen to be right in the middle. And what we're going to do is hit over here on the transform in our inspector. We're going to hit the master keyframe. I'm going to go ahead and zoom in. And then I'm going to Y up to get us a little bit centrally located, but I'm going to keep an eye on the bottom right here to make sure we're not going past the edge of the screen or the image there. So I'm going to go right about here. So now we're centrally located in the shot. We have everything keyframed, and we're going to go back to the start of the shot. So here's the trick to getting a smooth reframe on this. If we looked at the overlay on the reframe, we could see it was mostly in X position. So I'm just going to go over to X position and slide over to right about here. So you could see we have a flat plane between these keyframes here. Now you can use a jog wheel or your cursor keys to move forward. I'm going to keep going. Now you'd think you'd want to keep repositioning this as it starts to get off screen, but since it's linear, it's going to reposition it when you make the next keyframe. So I'm going to go to about here, and I will go ahead and make the X adjustment to get back to there. So let's see what we got so far. Now, because we started with that center zoom right about here, everything's looking pretty good. Once you pay attention to right here on this little overlay section, what we're going to do is as we scroll, you can see this actually moves on that graticule in real time. So these are your keyframes, and you can actually hit bracket to move back and forth between those. So if I choose this clip and hit bracket, it moves to the big keyframes, and then we have these little smaller ones right here. So let's go back to our last keyframe. We'll go forward a little more, maybe to here. It's still doing a pretty decent job. Now here we're moving up to the next big keyframe and our image is going to stop following it. So let's go to about here and I'm going to choose that clip again. X position to about there. You can see we just added some more keyframes. Now we're starting to go the other way. So I'm going to wait till she's just about off screen and I'm going to pull her back into here and then keep going. We're almost to the end of the clip here. So I'm going to go almost to the last frame because I want to have as little mini keyframes in between here as possible. So let's review that section now. All right, there we go. Now we can click on these keyframes and hit smooth. You can do that on all of them if you need to, and it'll smooth out all these movements, much like your keyframe editor down here, except when you have all selected, it gets a little clunky. And then since we're doing X and Y and these positions, you kind of have to keep track of the colors of all those. And unless you're doing like general graphics movements, it's kind of not as intuitive to move those around, in my opinion. But I kind of like the idea of being able to do it right up here in the preview overlay. So now if we hit play, this overlay will go away. We can watch. That doesn't look too bad. If there's something we wanted to adjust, we can physically zoom in on the overlay here. And if there was a keyframe, if we hit the brackets, we can move to one of them. And then we could actually manipulate these tangents here if we wanted to change the distance of our keyframes or even move it globally here. So it's pretty flexible to be able to edit right over top of your image here. And it does a pretty good job. So right here, we kind of got a weird movement right there. I don't like how that looks. Let's zoom in a little bit. You can still zoom and do some global controls right here if you needed to. So let's go here. I don't like this shift. I'm going to pay attention on this frame where she's located on the center. Come forward one frame and then back that up a little bit. So now we got a huge jump. I'll add another keyframe to there. So that smooths that out a little bit. That's where we kind of let it go a little bit in between keyframes, as you could see. So now we could hit smooth on our major keyframes. So as I said, you can hit bracket and that'll take you to each of your keyframes, where you could just right click and hit smooth, go to the next one. It was smoothed out and you could see these little tangents here. So if we zoom in, and all I'm doing is scrolling in here, and now you can see we have access to the tangent if we wanted to like make it a smoother transition. Z to zoom back out. We can go P for full screen. And now we have a smart reframe without having to have the studio reversion of Resolve. All right. Thanks for watching. As always, share this out if you found it helpful. And subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys on the next one.